Hello, dear participant. We gathered here today to give indigenous peoples the opportunity to gain knowledge of the United Nations system and mechanism dealing with human rights and indigenous peoples, so we can assist indigenous organizations and institutions in protecting and promoting the rights of the communities. I would like to thank the organizers, Tribal Link Foundation, and the United Nations Development Program for this initiative and unique online course to increase indigenous advocacy and awareness under the difficult pandemic time. Almost 100 years ago, in 1923, the groundwork toward recognition of indigenous rights began when representatives of indigenous communities of Canada and New Zealand attempted to bring pieces of their respective nations to the League of Nations. Both delegations were denied access because they had no standing in international law. Despite the League refused to hear them, this courageous attempts became the first step in ongoing battle for recognition of indigenous rights and contribute to the development of the movement against the so-called internal colonialism applied to struggles of oppressed groups within the boundaries of the state. Involvement of indigenous people's agenda within the United Nations framework offers a helpful testing ground for analyzing how indigenous claims to human rights protection and global response to them develop within the historical narrative and how current structures determine the trajectory of indigenous empowerment. The rights-based approach adopted by international organizations to address indigenous challenges became a key concept and a manifestation of global trend towards indigenous legal empowerment through the recognition of fundamental rights to self-determination, political participation, land rights, resources, and decision-making process. Established by the United Nations Human Rights Council in 2007, the Expert Mechanism on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples provides expertise on indigenous rights. In line with the United Nations Permanent Forum and Special Rapporteur, the mechanism is one of the main UN platforms where indigenous peoples, governments, NGOs, experts, and national human rights institutions submit advice and recommendation on the rights of indigenous peoples. The main normative framework of the mechanism is the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Therefore, its mandate is to give a better understanding of the provision of the UN DRIP and to propose concrete actions that state, indigenous peoples, civil society, international organizations, human rights institutions, and others can take for the promotion, protection, and fulfillment of the rights of indigenous peoples. The thematic expertise focusing mainly on studies and research-based advice. The expert mechanism prepares annual thematic studies on the status of rights of indigenous peoples worldwide in the achievement of the end of the declaration, focusing on particular topics. To date, the expert mechanism has carried out a variety of studies on core challenges facing indigenous communities, including the right to participate in decision-making, the role of languages and culture in the promotion and protection of the rights and identity of indigenous peoples, free, prior, and informed consent, land rights, and others. The EFSA mechanism also produces a report each year on its annual session. Through this report, it provides guidance, identifies and promotes good practices, lessons, and efforts learned regarding the steps to achieve UNDRIP goals. As for the country-specific activities, the mechanism provides member states, upon their request, recommendation and advice regarding the development of domestic legislation and policies related to the rights of indigenous peoples. Depending on the nature of the request, the country engagement may include country mission, training activities for state institutions, indigenous peoples organizations, national human rights institutions, and other stakeholders. Importantly, the mechanism can act as a mediator by engaging, assisting, and facilitating dialogue between member states, indigenous peoples, and private sector and other stakeholders. For time being, three country missions were successfully implemented: Finland, Mexico, and New Zealand. A request from indigenous peoples should be submitted to the Secretariat of the Exit Mechanism through email. Request should provide at least the following information: requesting institution or organization, name of the contact persons, description of the situation, steps that have been taken to address the issue, including any domestic remedies, expectations, actions by, and technical advice to be supplied by the mechanism, whether state authorities or other stakeholders have been consulted about or informed of the request submitted to the mechanism, and finally, proposed timeframe. In terms of compositions, the expert mechanism consists of 7 independent experts of indigenous origin, if possible, 1 from each of the 7 indigenous social cultural regions: Africa, Asia, Central and South America, and the Caribbean, the Arctic, Central and Eastern Europe, the Russian Federation, Central Asia and Transcaucasus, North America, and the Pacific. Served for 3-year period and may be re-elected for 1 additional period. The session is held for 1 week, usually in July, once a year in Geneva. Important to emphasize, the mechanism creates a space for indigenous youth and disabled persons to participate in the processes of the United Nations, which is essential for indigenous rights promotion and realization. The full and effective participation of indigenous youth can provide proper representation of different stakeholders and strengthen exchange of indigenous peoples in the world. The Indigenous Caucasus session organized at Emory brings together an open to all indigenous delegation. It represents a unique opportunity for indigenous communities to meet for exchange information and experience. During the caucus session, joint statements, position, and recommendation are developed that often taken into consideration by the expert mechanism. Additionally, side events organized by indigenous delegation, the national institutions, NGOs are held during the MVP session. This type of meetings on indigenous issues offer a unique opportunity to meet and exchange knowledge with the key actors in the sphere of indigenous rights. The continued involvement of various indigenous peoples' communities worldwide are critical for the mechanism, along with various indigenous rights mechanisms and organizations to function in a proper and sustainable manner. During annual session, Recommend Information Center, known as DOSIP, one of the main supporters of indigenous peoples in Geneva, provide technical assistance to indigenous peoples and local communities, computing, internet access, translation of the text and statements to and from English, Spanish, French, and Russian, interpretation during the caucus, side event, informal conversation, and other technical support. The MRIP session presents an opportunity also to make an appointment with a special rapporteur on the rights of indigenous people, whose mandate is to gather information and communication on violation of the human rights and fundamental freedoms of indigenous population. I would like also to draw your attention to other 3 different half-day panels under the annual sessions of MRIP, such as interactive dialogue on enhancing indigenous people's participation based on the United Nations General Assembly decision, strategic and coordination panel of all United Nations mandate holders, including MRIP members, permanent forum chair, special rapporteur, voluntary foundation, and Human Rights Council top staff. And the 3rd one is the regional meetings with respective MRIP members. We have exchange and awareness meetings based on the regional challenges and peculiarities. The expert mechanism upholds the highest standards of efficiency, competence, and integrity. It neither seek nor accept instructions from any government, individuals, governmental or non-governmental organizations, or pressure group whatsoever. despite progress in indigenous rights recognition, backed up by the development of international law, there are still a lot of obstacles indigenous peoples face. In fact, the last 20 years, there is a growing body of challenges in methods, scale, and sophistication. In other words, while colonial period is historically over, it continues in more sophisticated forms, reflected in state development assistance programs, extractive company strategy in regards to resource development on indigenous lands. Changes in the form and strategies of modern colonialism also manifest in the growing range of place involved in power relations structure. In line with the new forms of inequality, ongoing colonization of native lands remains at the top of the agenda for many indigenous peoples worldwide. Looking ahead at the post-pandemic world, the biggest challenge and number one task for all countries will be economic recovery. And the greatest fear for indigenous peoples right now, while trying to kickstart economy, the government may choose to ignore provisions on sustainability and biodiversity, and once again target indigenous people's lands and resources instead, and once again we will witness a race of fast economic gain at the cost of people and nature. In 2020, the expert mechanism proposed to the Human Rights Council to hold a panel discussion during its 48th session in September 2021 on the human rights of indigenous peoples facing the global COVID pandemic with a special focus on land rights. And in conclusion, in the play between global institutions and indigenous peoples, hence, has been important in the process of rights revitalization. Where the government often builds walls, this kind of international institutions like expert mechanism would really create an influence and shape the future of indigenous peoples and new global agenda. Owing to the joint work and partnership development with the United Nations human rights system, indigenous peoples' institutions and their communities are more frequently granted a seat and represented at the decision-making table instead of being on the menu. I would like to thank you for your attention and send my solidarity to you and to your community.